Welcome everybody back to another Dark Souls. Wait. This isn't a Dark Souls 3 build video. And you know what? You're right. Welcome everybody back to another Souls-like build video. Today, man, we're playing Lords of the Fallen. I pray that each and every one of you guys are all having a blessed day. If you guys are new to my channel, welcome. I am God's Chosen One. And for those of you guys that are returning, you guys are amazing as always, man. So, before I jump into the build, the name of this build is OP Faith Build. Pretty plain and simple. Now, one thing I will say before we jump into this build is that this build isn't overpowered as far as AR or attack power goes. I will get into that more detail as to why it's OP. But first, let's jump to the stats, see what we're rocking, see what we're doing. Alright. Our strength is at 8, vitality is 24, 34 faith, 20 endurance, 8 agility, and 0 luck. So let me go over real quick what points I spec'd to first as I went through the game. So I started off with faith, jumped that up to 25 at the very beginning. I was hitting like a truck. Then I put points both in the vitality and endurance, jumped them up to 15 each. After that, I put 5 more points into faith, bumping it up to 30. And then I put 5 more points each into vitality and endurance, which raised them both up to 20. Then I put points into faith, and I realized that the weapon that we are using hard caps its attack power at 32 faith, I believe it is. And then I just put the rest, you know, the remaining points into vitality. Alright, let's go over the ability real quick. The ability tree that we chose for this build is the Solace ability tree. And pretty much the bread and butter ability that you're going to be using on this build is called Shelter. A protective shell that highly increases all types of defense and mirrors the incoming damage. Now, there's also something that this build, or this, not this build, this ability does not tell you. Let me show you guys real quick. Alright, check this out, guys. Look at my health bar real quick. Look at that. Look at how much health I'm regenerating. Insane amounts. So this helps you guys throughout your journey or your playthrough of Lords of the Fallen on not having to use the your potions, pretty much. Alright. Now. Alright, let's check out the gear, what we're rocking. Alright, for the weapons. Let's see. So I started off with, let's see, where is it? The Defiance Hammer, because I started this build off with the Cleric build, because it has the highest faith setup. So, started off with the Cleric setup, and Defiance was the first weapon that you're given, which is a decent hammer. It doesn't really scale with faith. It scales with strength, I believe. So I was using that for a while, and then I found the Pain Hammer, which is this hammer right here, which scaled off of faith, which helped me out. But then, shortly after, I found the Quamar Staff, which was amazing. It was really, really good. I highly recommend that staff for a faith build at the very beginning of the game. And then, after that, we obtained the Clawfinger Greataxe, which is the main weapon of this build. So the reason why we stuck with this weapon for the base, you know, rest of the game, is because I actually got the special version of the Clawfinger Greataxe. There's two versions. There's the regular version, and then there's the special version. And granted, yes, the AR is not the highest. It's, you know, 118. it's mediocre. See, stare hammer is actually better than that. But what makes this weapon better than those is the one-handed heavy attack right here. And it shoots a scythe out of the ground. A lot of the times, toppling over your enemies, even the bigger enemies, hitting them behind their shield. So that is the reason why we are rocking the Clawfinger Greataxe special version. And the only way that you can get the special version of the Clawfinger Greataxe is you have to have the Worshipper, which is where you get this weapon. You have to fight the Worshipper boss and have the Worshipper boss kill two of his minions. Okay? Now, going to shields, I didn't use shields. There's not really any reason to use shields in this game. But I mainly use the gauntlet to shield myself whenever I did try to block any kind of attack. And I normally never use the explosive gauntlet version or the blast because they both suck in my opinion. Explosive, you have to be really, really close. Blast, or is it other way around? Explosive basically shoots kind of like a grenade and it rolls around everywhere. Blast, you have to be right in their face, which I don't really care for. So I mainly use the projectile, and I put a higher fire rune on there just so that way whenever if you do hit them and they're blocking, they at least take some tick damage. All right, moving on to our rings. We are using the Faithful Disciple ring. The reason why we are using this ring in particular is because it regenerates our energy, which is how we're able to cast our abilities as well as use the gauntlet and use the heavy attack of the Clawfinger Greataxe. All right, going over armor real quick. Now, at the beginning of the game, started out with the cleric armor, of course, because that's the starting armor, which is decent, but we soon changed that out, and after the first boss that we're about to fight, we got the symmetry armor, heavy armor. Then we went from symmetry armor up to, where is it at? Living Legend. All right. And then after Living Legend, we found, where is it? The Griffin heavy armor set. And I just basically stuck with that through the remainder of the game. So, but all right, guys, we're gonna jump into this boss fight, show you guys what this build can do. Oh, got knocked on my ass. All right, and by the way, this is a new game plus, by the way. All right, we got our damage right here. There we go. Back off. Now, like I stated, this build is pretty much a ranged build. Ooh, got us. Like, you're very comfortable being at range because you do just so much damage. Here we go. Back off. Look at that tick damage too, by the way, on the fire from the gauntlet. So good. Actually, it's quite a bit of damage right there. Another thing to note as well, as you can see right there, each time I try to go for my heavy attack, if you actually hit the NPC's shield with it, it stops your special ability from your Clawfinger Greataxe from happening. All right, what we're gonna do now is we're just gonna, oh shit. We're going to take a giant sword straight to the face. We're going to pop a prayer right there. Have him attack that. And we're just going to get free damage off. There we go. There we go. First phase done. He knocked off some of his armor. We're going to keep pelting him with the fire. Look at how much that does, though. Look how good that tick damage is. Didn't get the heavy attack. I'm gonna keep shelter on just in case if we do get hit more. Ooh, that didn't even stun him. See what I mean? Like, some of the bigger enemies, especially bosses, they don't get stunned by that attack at all. But what is good about it is that if they have shields and stuff like that, or if they turtle a lot like this guy does, you can get in behind them because that ability actually, you know, hits them from behind. Ooh, ow. There we go. Ow. Got smacked again. Damn. Again. He's just smacking us around. It's all good. He's slowly melting. Slowly melting. I'm gonna hit him with this. There we go. Hit him with another. With this. Damage. There we go. There we go. The overhead. That's what we want. And with that, back off. Hit him with the gauntlet. Dude, just... this is just a relentless barrage of attack. And, like, if I really wanted to, I would never get hit by this guy, ever. Ow. But it's all good. You know, even if we do get hit by him and we take damage, then we go like this. We use shelter. Look at how much health we I can't even talk. Look at how much health we regenerate, man. I mean, it's ridiculous. This build is just so dirty. Look at that. Oh, now he's gonna go into his ballerina stage. There we go. Just gonna keep pelting him from afar. That should be it. There we go. Ow. Ooh. He got us with that one. Keep the damage going. Oh, shit. Got blocked there by the rubble. We're gonna pop a prayer. I think we're just gonna end him right here. There we go. He's on fire. There we go. We're just gonna... ow. End him. There we go. First warden, no match. And you get all this, like, all this, you know, all the weapons and everything just very, very early on in the game. So it just makes your playthrough so much easier. Anyways, guys, that's my build. That's my very first Lords of the Fallen build. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you guys like Souls-like and RPG content, I will be making a lot more of that kind of content very, very soon. Anyways, guys, if you guys do like this kind of content, make sure that you guys hit that sub button for me. Anyways, guys, I'm out. Peace. 'Cause I dream so much, dream so much, I would do so much, do so much.